There she is.
Hi, Kathryn.
How are you doing?
Doing good.
Good. It's been a while. It's so wonderful to have you here today. Learn more about what you've been up to. We have here Dr. Barbara Van Dahlen. She's the executive director of the Prevents Task Force to End Veteran Suicide. And really all suicide. She's also the founder of Give an Hour. And she's here to talk to us today about the Prevents Pledge to Reach. So I'm really grateful to have you, and I can't wait to learn more about what you've been up to and doing. So I am going, with that said, hand the floor over to you.
Thank you, Kathryn. And I'm proud to be participating again this year, thrilled to be part of this important week and this digital summit. Congrats to everybody who pulled this together. So I believe that we have some slides that we are going to share. And actually, what I'm really going to focus on today, Kathryn mentioned the Pledge to Reach, which we would love for everyone to take as you hear the work that we're doing. Today, I'm going to really focus on a brand new tool that we launched yesterday. So you all are really some of the first people to learn about the How We Reach coaching tool. We can go to the next slide. So as we know, suicide is a huge tragedy in the U.S., but around the world. We know that in the United States, we have seen an increase in suicide deaths over the last 25 years. The numbers have increased 33%. And we know that we lose 132 Americans each day to suicide. We know that in a given year, over the last several years, we've seen approximately 47,000. And we know that nearly 800,000 people die globally each year from suicide. And this was before the pandemic. So we will be studying and tracking and looking and understanding. But we're not waiting. We're all moving forward to do everything that we can to try to prevent suicide, again, in our country and globally. The program that I lead, I am the executive director of Prevents, which is an all of government, all of nation effort, is focused here in the U.S. It was created with the vision to prevent our veteran suicide, but the only way we can do that is if we tackle suicide as a nation. So that's what Kathryn was referencing. This is an all of nation effort with our veterans, and our Department of Veterans Affairs leading the way, but we are an interagency office. And even though we are focused in the U.S., we have been in conversation with WHO about this issue globally. And in fact, the Prevents model and the work that we're doing will be featured in the upcoming WHO Guide Live Life. So we're very proud of that partnership and excited to continue to work together. Next slide. So part of the work that we have done, we're really still very new. We were created, the interagency office was created in 2019. And then we did our work during the last year during the pandemic, as all of us have done. And we focus on four strategic areas to do this work, to create an all of nation effort, to create an all of government effort. We focus on communications, research, programs, and policies. Our work is less about creating new programs, new research, and more about coordinating, improving collaboration, facilitating collaboration. But the one area that we have gotten very creative is that we created the first ever here in the U.S. National Suicide Prevention Public Health Campaign called REACH. And you can find it if you go to reach.gov. How simple is that? Just go to reach.gov and you can see everything that I'm talking about today. So we created this public health campaign for everyone, because everyone has to be part of preventing suicide. And all of us, we have all been touched by mental health challenges in ourselves, our families, substance use and misuse, and many, many of us sadly have been touched by suicide. And so this program, this campaign has many different facets, many different pieces. I'm going to tell you about a few of them today, but you can see some of the language that we use. When we reach to those in need, we will provide hope. When we reach because we are hurting, we will find help. When we reach, we will prevent suicide. The idea behind REACH, as I said, REACH is for everyone. And the focus of the work is both us learning how and encouraging everyone to reach out to those we see who are struggling, but also to encourage all of us to reach for help ourselves when we are hurting. You can see in the beginning, the work since we've done since July, we've already created over 3 billion impressions. We have 15,500 pledges. That's the pledge that Kathryn referenced. So please come to reach.gov and take that pledge. 8 million visits to our website, 771 million views of some of our PSAs, and you're going to see one of those in a couple of minutes. Next slide. So 2021 is the year to reach. That's what we had decided long before we knew really how challenging 2020 was going to be. And it means a lot of different things to a lot of people. You know, for some people, 2021 is the year to reach because of all that we've gone through in this last year. And I'm not going to argue with that. It's also the year to reach because we can now reach, because there are efforts like this digital summit and the great work that is happening in so many countries around the world to prevent suicide. And so we're very, very proud that we are doing a number of activities to really make this the year to reach. And we want all of you to be involved. So I believe that next up we have the video that we're going to show. So I know there are production team behind the scenes is going to show that now. Thank you for showing that. So hopefully you could see that in that little video, our messaging, you know, we have been through a lot this year, and we need to be especially mindful to reach to those in our community, in our network, in our family, who are struggling, who are suffering. And we need to be mindful and pay attention to our own emotional health and well-being, which is why I love this summit. I love the focus on happiness and all the things that we can do that are proactive to facilitate and to nurture our emotional health and well-being. But these challenges existed before, and they will exist after if we don't do more to take care of our emotional health and well-being and the emotional health and well-being of those we love. So there are some other things that we've done to make this the year to reach. One, we decided that while we want people to be reaching every day, we want them to be mindful of the people that are around them, their coworkers, their community, their neighbors. You know, I think about in this age of pandemic, you know, we have a puppy that we've been raising during this, and she needs a lot of exercise. So we're constantly out in the neighborhood walking. And, you know, we see the same people and we nod or we say hello. And you can feel the stress and you can feel the pain of people as you pass them. You can also see families being, you know, supportive of each other and walking together and taking their kids on bikes. And we can experience a lot just if we tune in. So we're encouraging everyone to do that, to recognize those moments to reach, we call them. Notice and then take action. A little bit I'm going to talk about how to take action. But before I get to that, so we want people to be reaching every day, but we thought it would be helpful if we created a day every month that we really want people look. Everybody's busy, they're Zooming, they're working, they're taking care of their families. It'd be helpful if we designated a day. So we decided the first Sunday of the month is the day to reach. So we're working with our partners and our ambassadors and all of you and on social media and traditional media to really help move us toward this notion that whatever else is going on in your week, in your month, think about those people that first Sunday of every month. And we're helping, we're pushing this out through social media. And we're using themes. The first Sunday that we happened to focus on was the first Sunday in February. And it happened to be Super Bowl Sunday. So people were here in the US, were gathered together. to watch the Super Bowl. So that was a good time to say, you know, while you're having those Zoom parties where you're watching the game, ask people, how are you doing, really? And listen, ask them and share with them how you're doing. The next one we had was just past March 7th with Women's History Month. So we encourage people, reach out to the women in your life who have been bearing so much of the brunt of this pandemic because of economic factors affecting more women than men, because of the burden of taking care of the family and kids while people are homeschooling and never intended to do so. So each month we will have a theme. April, we're going to focus on work-life balance. In May, of course, is Mental Health Awareness Month. So this is one way we're helping to facilitate this notion that this really is the year to reach. Next slide. So I'm very excited to share with all of you. As I said, yesterday we launched the How We Reach coaching tool. Here's why we did this. And then I'm going to show you a little bit and tell you where you can learn more, because this is an amazing tool that we are so proud of. So as we went around the country before the pandemic, and then we were doing Zooms with people all around the country during the pandemic, we kept hearing a similar theme, which is we understand the importance of reaching. We understand that each of us has a role to play, that each of us has the power to reach out, show compassion, kindness, but we don't know how. We don't know what to say. We don't know what to do. We don't want to do the wrong thing. And those people who themselves are struggling shared the same kinds of messages with us, that they feel awkward telling people that they care about, that they're hurting, that they're struggling. They try to buck up, you know, they try to be tough and manage it all. So we listened and we gathered information from all of the great suicide prevention efforts that are available to us. And we created the first ever How We Reach coaching tool. And that's what you're going to learn a little bit about. Next slide. So again, thinking about sort of our philosophy and the work we are doing, as we face the tragedy of suicide in our nation, and I would say around the world, we must reach beyond what we have done before. We must change the way we think about, talk about, and address emotional pain and suffering. Suicide is preventable. Suicide is preventable. We know that. But only if we empower ourselves with the knowledge, tools, and resources we need. So we began our work focusing on knowledge, education, educating people about the importance, trying to dispel myths, giving them resources, access to resources. And now we have a new tool. Next slide. So, introducing the How We Reach tool. We're so proud and excited because this is a very simple tool. There's a lot packed in it, but what you see right here is basically the foundation, if you will. And then if you go into the tool, and for those of you who are interested, let me see if I can get there on my little, we have on our phones, yeah, I'm trying to do this. You can see the little icon right there. It's a little, it looks like that. It looks like the beacon. That you can download this. This is an app so that everybody, we want everybody to have it at their fingertips. So what I'm showing you here is the first sort of, this is not what it looks like on the app, but it's basically this information. And then it goes deeper. It goes deeper into the tool. So what we did is we created a mnemonic, R-E-A-C-H, that we use for the five steps that everyone can take if they're looking to provide care and support to someone they care about, or if they're looking to get help for themselves. So in our mnemonic, and the good thing is you don't need to memorize it. You just need to remember it's reach and reach.gov, because it's right there. You can go to the website, you can go to, and on the website, there's a PDF. You can download it and share it if you like paper and need that. You can also download the app, same place, go to reach.gov. But R-E-A-C-H, reach out and ask. If you're concerned about someone, ask, how are you really? Listen and offer hope. E, engage them about possible risk factors and things that are happening in their life that may be contributing. We all do better when we understand why we are feeling what we're feeling and what's happening to us. Then you can create plans. A, attend to their safety. Unless you are concerned about your safety, stay with them. And as I said, if you go deeper into the tool on the next page and the next page, you'll learn about why and how to attend to someone's safety, and that you might you can take them to be assessed by a mental health professional. We don't expect anyone to be a mental health professional except those of us who are, but there are things that everyone can do. C, connect them to resources such as supportive friends, family, professionals, or a crisis line. You know, bring in the resources, wrap around somebody who's hurting until they're on the other side. These are often acute experiences that will pass if we get them through it. It's a permanent solution that people make to an acute situation, and we're trying to break through that. H, help them make and maintain a plan to stay safe, encourage them to share it with others. And then we walk through the same steps, but as they apply to us. When we reach because we are hurting, we reach out to someone we trust, we engage that person or persons in conversations about what's going on for us. We attend to our safety. We tell them if we have lethal means in our possession that we need to store elsewhere or get out of the house. Connect them to family, friends, and other professionals, and help others understand how to keep us safe. So this is the basic, but there's a lot more. But even it is very simple and easy to digest. We also provide even language to help people with those difficult conversations. Next slide. This is what it looks like on your app. So it's great, it's simple, it's basic. Next slide. So we're going to keep doing our work. We want people to take that Prevents pledge by going to reach.gov. We want you to engage and join us in the Day to Reach every first Sunday of every month. This is the year to reach. If you feel passionately about this, send us a video. We'll post it. We post people's videos and we share them. And then please help us get this coaching tool out. I shared it with all my family yesterday. My daughters were so excited. They're both in their 20s and they can see how important this is for their community. So I think that's my last slide. I'm right on time. There I am. Please reach out if we can be of help, if you're interested in partnering. Thank you, Kathryn and team, for this great opportunity. And together, we will prevent suicide. Thank you.
Wonderful. Thank you so much. You've done so much in such a short period of time. It's pretty amazing. And we do know that everyone needs at least one person to talk to. So I love that you're helping facilitate those conversations, encouraging them. I think it's amazing that the first Sunday of every month, you have a specific kind of framework. Who should I reach out to for this? So it's really, really wonderful. So thank you so much for joining us today.
Always happy to help and be part of this wonderful week. Thank you, Kathryn. Take care.
Thank you. Yep, you too.